Hello and welcome to the 2012 Miss, Miss Teen, and Mrs. BC pageant.
We have 46 beautiful women behind us, all waiting to go on stage. I can't wait to see what's going to happen next.
It's going to be a blast. I'm glad I'm not judging it tonight.
And our 30-minute countdown starts now. Ladies, we're on in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Tonight from Fort Langley, the birthplace of BC, it's the 2012 Miss, Mrs. and Miss Teen BC pageant with your host, Mr. World Canada 2007, Darren Storchley. The reigning Miss BC, North Vancouver's own Cheryl Dietrich. The reigning Mrs. BC, the pride of Maple Ridge, Carla Ways. And now, let's meet the 46 contestants from all across the province, who tonight compete for the title of Miss, Mrs. and Miss Teen BC.
Contestants from across the province, beginning with the young ladies from beautiful BC's interior. Beginning with Miss Neighbors Computers.
Believe in your dreams and follow your heart is what my grandfather taught me as a little girl. And now I'm here at Miss BC. Thank you, Grandpa. From Grand Forks, I'm Amanda Chambray.
Miss Marshall's Home Living Kelowna.
I'm a pharmacy technician from the heart of the Okanagan. I am Christina O'Connor.
Miss Tri-City Dental Center.
Sharing smiles, positive vibes, and green love with everyone. My name is Kirsten Ellis, representing 100 Mile House.
Miss Greenwood.
Simplicity is the key to success. From Canada's smallest and historical city called Greenwood, I'm Ribbiner Ollie.
Miss KB Orchards.
Follow your dreams, for if you dream, you shall become. So here I am, a small town girl from Kirmes, BC. My name is Sandy.
And now let's meet the ladies from the Sunshine Coast and Vancouver Island. Beginning with Miss Total Body Laser.
Hello, my name is Alyssa Harkin. I am from Seashell, BC, and I love figure skating, working hard, and keeping active.
Miss Bride's Closet.
I'm a small town girl ready to take on BC. From Parksville, I am Alyssa Kelly.
Miss Canpro Construction Limited.
Hello, my name is Therese Johnson Ferguson, and I'm from Victoria. I'm a third-year student at the University of Victoria in Child and Youth Care.
Miss Bliss Gowns and Events.
I love to try new things while making a positive impact from the beautiful harbor city of Nanaimo. I am Kendall Angelkovic.
Miss BC Smoke Shop.
Just an island girl on a mission to stop bullying and end hate. From scenic Victoria, I'm Miku.
Miss Qualicum Beach.
Recently graduated from Vancouver Island University and aspired to be a teacher, I am Philippa Byrne from Qualicum Beach on Vancouver Island.
And here come the ladies who put the word great in Greater Vancouver. With Miss N.A. Natural Medicine Center.
Thank goodness, my dream is alive, bringing my passion for healthcare to the world from the home of the Vancouver Canucks. My name is Ada Gill.
Miss Hardy Real Estate Team.
Good evening, everyone. Working as a biotechnologist, aspiring to be a medical doctor with a passion for global philanthropy. If you dream it, you must do it. From Vancouver, Kasari Akustin.
Miss Head Over Heels.
From being a loud, wild child, and then an obnoxious teenager, and now an aspiring pediatrician, from Vancouver, my name is Charmaine Charity Burrito.
Miss Vision Event Photography.
A creative swimwear and lingerie designer from beautiful Vancouver, I am Danielle Keeping.
Miss Van City Bake Shop.
Studying linguistics and hoping to pursue a career in speech pathology. My name is Isabel, and I represent the rich city of Richmond.
Miss Tan Popo Sushi.
I wanted to make a difference in the world and have a positive impact on society. And through science, I found a means to do so. I'm a biochemistry major, an aspiring physician, and a proud representative of my community. From Burnaby, I'm Jade.
Miss Westgrove Properties.
Life's what you make it. I'm making it in a male-dominant industry, working towards becoming a construction manager at West Group Properties. From Vancouver, my name is Kirsten Slade.
Miss Chronicle Music Group.
An ambitious young lady striving to reach her goals. From Vancouver, my name is Laura Chow.
Miss Fiji, Nigeria.
From the beautiful shores of Fiji Islands, a God-fearing woman with a passion for youth and mission, in my final year as a double major at UBC. From Vancouver, I am Rebecca Olu.
Miss West Vancouver Martial Arts.
Currently studying health science at Simon Fraser with future ambitions of becoming a pediatrician, I am Sarah Sanat from beautiful West Vancouver.
Miss Mantique.
Studying forensic science in hopes of becoming a physician, my optimism and thirst for new opportunities is the reason I'm here. From Burnaby, my name is Sarah Saeed.
Miss West Core Group.
I'm a BCIT broadcast journalism student, and I believe that achieving goals is stepping outside the box. I'm Svee Baines from beautiful South Vancouver.
Miss Faith Wilson Realty Group.
As a French preschool teacher, I believe it's substantial to nurture our planet and to educate our youth. From Vancouver, I'm Talia Ganes.
Miss Latin Fitness Studio.
My nights of tears and fears have gone. My day of overcoming and celebration is here. A proud UBC alumna and staff from Canada's best run city, Burnaby, my name is Wendy.
And now here they are, the hometown girls from right here in the Fraser Valley. Miss Bandit Transport.
I'm pursuing my dream as an entrepreneur in the health and beauty industry, helping you look good, feel good, live healthy and happily. From Port Coquitlam, my name is Ashley Coulthard.
Miss White Rock Hair Art.
I was always told that I couldn't do it, but here I stand and I can do anything I set my mind to. From White Rock, I am Ashley Brooks.
Miss Flying Wedge Pizza.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am a full-time customer service representative at Save-On Foods, and in my second year at SFU, from Surrey, my name is Ashley King.
Miss Pharmacity.
Find the happiness that lies within you. Life is what you make it. Live it and love it. From Abbotsford, I'm DP Diol.
Miss Brown Social House Richmond.
A group fitness instructor in the making, with music constantly flowing through my veins. From wonderful White Rock, I'm Desiree Tremblay.
Miss Hitchrich Law.
This
The last 21 years has taught me that everything happens for a reason. I am currently working at Preston Chevrolet, and I will be attending school in the fall for media and communications. From Langley, my name is Hannah Sue.
Miss Total Label.
My dad taught me that life can change within seconds, so make every second count. Don't be afraid to take chances. From Abbotsford, I'm Harp Dillon.
Miss Lucy Bruni Photography.
Never be afraid about what could go wrong and always be positive about what could go right. By being a contestant for Miss BC, I am doing just that. From Chilliwack, my name is Jessica Wesson.
Miss Mills Pictures.
I'm continuing my musical endeavors and I'm an active volunteer. From Delta, my name is Kiana Passmore.
Miss Apples Cosmetics.
As CEO of Miss Apples Cosmetics, I am passionate about confidence in women and their self-esteem. Proud to be a Northern girl from Fort St. John living in Maple Ridge, I am Michelle Apples.
Miss Murray Hyundai.
A conscientious student and volunteer by day, but an aspiring singer by night. From North Delta, my name is Michelle Schultz.
Miss West Coast Contortion and Acrobatics.
Bendy and twisty I am to live my passion. Bendy and twisty I am, a contortionist I'll be to live my passion, a preschool teacher you will see. I'm Nicole Johnson from Pitt Meadows, BC.
Miss Salon Picasso.
As Wayne Gretzky once said, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Fashionista, a full-time student, and an aspiring YouTube makeup artist. From Abbotsford, I'm Pre Dodgelaw.
Miss HWN Lawyers.
Education is the collapse of ignorance and the building of civilization. From Surrey, pursuing a career in education, my name is Rachel Hunt.
Miss Langley Fine Arts School.
Just like our students from the Langley Fine Arts School, I started with crayons, and today I am majoring in criminology to help victims of sexual abuse and exploitation. From Surrey, I am Sangeeta.
Miss Fluid Day Spa.
SFU undergrad, biochemistry lab assistant, and aspiring doctor, my name is Stephanie from Surrey.
Let's welcome the contestants for Mrs. British Columbia 2012. Beginning with Miss United Carpet Victoria.
I'm a recent UBC graduate with a passion for creating sustainable communities. From Vancouver, I am Amy Moranitz.
Miss BrainInjuryLaw.ca.
For the last 4 years, I have been married to my best friend and my biggest supporter. Thank you for believing in me, Lanny. I love you. Proud to be a Mrs. I'm Andrea Can from Campbell River.
Miss Chris Cleaning.
I have been working in the medical field for 7 years. I love to help people. From North Vancouver, I am Danielle Bermel.
Mrs. EM Beautician School.
Full-time mom and recent graduate from EM Beautician School. From Surrey, I'm Marissa.
Mrs. Georgia Pacific Realty.
Don't take no for an answer. As a real estate agent, working with Georgia Pacific Realty from commercial to residential, I'm Shayla DeRider from Surrey.
And there you have it, 46 reasons why British Columbia definitely is the best place on earth. Thank you. And there you have the evening gown event for Miss and Mrs. BC 2012. Maybe we can give them one last round of applause. Even when they can't see you, they can hear you, and it really, really encourages them. All right, I am about to ask for the judges' results to be brought down to me. I'm probably more nervous than all of you back there, and 10 years of this does not make it any easier. Thank you. Okay, I have a secret now that I get to share. But before I do, the ladies know I always have a surprise or something that I want to share. And I have to try to find a way to keep this secret. See why they don't let me do live television? To keep this secret and pull something else from the other pocket. So unclassy. The manners and etiquette lady is not happy right now. Okay. So, working with these 46 girls has been absolute honor for me. And before we narrow down the field to 15, I have a little poem that I would like to share that was on my mom's refrigerator from ever since I can remember. That when things possibly did not go the way that we thought they should, we were referred to this poem. And as a kid, it could have been from not winning a baseball game or not doing as well in a piano recital or just being bad. This is what was read to me sometimes after a spanking. And ladies, I would like to you to really take note of these words tonight. The contest lasts for moments, although the training has taken years. It wasn't the winning alone that was worth the work and the tears. The applause will be forgotten, the prize will be misplaced, but those long, hard hours of practice will never be a waste. For in trying to win, you build a skill. You learn that winning depends on will. You never grow by how much you win, you only grow by how much you put in. So any new challenge you've just begun, put forth your best and you have already won. Thank you, Mom, for that. Thank you, Mom. Mom right here for that. She hasn't missed a show in 10 years. So suspenseful. Okay, here we go. These names will be announced in no particular order whatsoever. I will ask each girl to step forward and then make a line right down here in front of me. Okay. Now, you're not looking, are you? No. Okay, no particular order. Our top finalists are, number one, from Qualicum Beach, Philippa Byrne. From Victoria Nitubor. See, North Vancouver sends us Danielle Burnell. The great city of Vancouver Sappy tonight for Rebecca Olu. Vancouver continues, Ada Gu. My hometown, Surrey, sends Desiree Tremblay. Vancouver again, Talia Nass. Danielle Keeping from Vancouver. And come on down, Kazar Jacobson, Vancouver. Nanaimo, Kendall Angelkovic. Thank you. from our capital city, Victoria Emmy Morantes. Stephanie Monkman of Surrey. That leaves just three names left. From one of our smallest communities in the province, Karamia Sandeepangag. Welcome Chilliwack, Jessica Wesson. Have you been counting out there? How many names are left? That's right, one name on here, 46 in my heart. The one name on this sheet comes from right here in Langley, Hannah Seaman. Now, I have just told you the names of Miss and Mrs. BC. Welcome our top 15 finalists in the 2012 competition. And all 46 girls from across the province who have worked so hard in the last 4 days. Let's hear it for all of them.
The Miss BC Pageant 2012 is sponsored by McDonald's Aldergrove, Flying Wedge Pizza, Classic Catering.
See, I have no idea what's going to happen next. We're about to interview each finalist. 10 years of this has really told me I have no idea what type of answers they're going to give. I know this will be a lot of fun. Let's begin the interview competition. Philippa Byrne, of her life behind us. Hello, Philippa. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So nice to share the stage with you. I have a question for you. I mean, of course, you don't know necessarily what I'm going to ask you, but I do know some things about you and all the girls I've learned in the past 4 days. Now, your message to the world is putting each other's needs before our own. That sounds like a really good concept to me. Explain what that means and how you implement that into your life.
Thank you very much, and thank you everyone for being here this evening. I believe that we should all put each other's needs before our own for a few reasons. In life, we're only given one opportunity and one chance to be something, to be whatever we want as well. Never settle for anything less. And therefore, put each other before yourself, because if you can help other people, then you can help yourself, and we can all grow all together in unison.
Thank you very much, Philippa. Miss Qualicum Beach. Let's welcome Neetu Brower. Now, you were one of the first girls to arrive on Friday from the island, and I have noticed you had so much fun. You're always laughing. You're always smiling. What is one of the best experiences you have had here this weekend?
One of the best experiences that I've had here this weekend is meeting all of these wonderful girls. They all have such great ambition and passion towards their charities, and that inspires me for my charity as well.
Thank you very much, Neetu. Thank you. Hi, Miss BC. We found her. You know, only having a few hours left as Miss BC, I know somewhere in the province they're calling you for one last time. Maybe I'm going to give you these cards, because she has kept very good track of me this year and always knows where both of us need to be, whatever community it may be on that day. Okay, so let's bring out Danielle Brumel. Now, one of the things I learned about you is your passion and commitment to researching women's rights. I am wondering, here in Canada, are we there yet, or what do we still need to do?
Thank you. I just want to say, first of all, what a blessing it is to be here this weekend and join Miss BC. And your question? I don't think we're quite there yet. I think that there's a lot of women out there that seem to not believe in themselves nowadays, and it hurts my heart. I just want people to be more confident in themselves and believe in themselves and achieve their goals.
Thank you very much, Danielle. My pleasure. Here she comes, Rebecca Olu. Words that you live by. To give back in full every form of goodness you have ever received. How do you apply that?
I've been so blessed to live a privileged life and be surrounded by loving and supportive people. And I look around, especially the area that I live, Hastings and Nanaimo, and there's so many people who don't have love. They don't have somebody to tell them that they're worth anything. And that's what my heart bends to do, is to just let everybody that I meet know that they matter in whatever way that I can. That's how I try to freely give back every form of goodness that I've ever received.
Thank you very much, Rebecca. Ada Gu is going to join us right now. Always, always has a smile on her face. Even now. Hi, Ada. Look, we meet again right here on the Miss BC stage in the finals. What is your definition of true beauty?
I think that inner beauty truly comes from your passion for your cause. It comes from being dedicated to being hardworking. It comes from being able to overcome obstacles, from overcoming challenges, and being able to be there for other people. To me, inner beauty is being able to support those that you love, to be able to support the causes that you care about, and to always stand behind what you say and what you believe in. That is a true leader, a true role model, and someone who is true inner beauty. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ada. My pleasure once again. Desiree Tremblay will join us at this point. Hi, Desiree. Now, Desiree, one of the things we asked all the girls here is, who is someone that they would most like to meet? And who did you say, and why did you choose him?
Thank you. That's a great question. I chose the Dalai Lama as someone I would truly like to meet. My mother actually met him, and she said that when you walked into the room, it was his presence and his energy, it was life-changing. And just to be in a room with someone who has that kind of energy and that kind of wisdom and that spirit, to me, that would be amazing to just kind of absorb some of that.
You have that energy and spirit as well, my dear. Thank you very much, Desiree. Talia is going to join us at this point. Now, I'm going to learn something from I've learned a lot from a lot of the girls. Now, the person you most like to meet is someone I have not heard of, but I'm so excited to learn about her. So who is that?
The person I would most like to meet is Jane Goodall. She's a world-leading primatologist, and she was the first woman to ever go, and the first woman and the youngest woman to ever go into the wild with the apes, and she has now moved on to youth and still working with animals and every day.
Thank you. Just before we go, I want to give you an opportunity to wave to somebody watching at home. Your dog, Jade, who ate the door. I learned that this weekend as well. Wave to Jade.
Jude.
Jude! I know I can never read my writing. I am sorry. Sorry, Jude. Thank you very much, Talia. Danielle Keeping is joining us now. Now, who is the person you would most like to meet and why?
On my response, I wrote Ellen DeGeneres. Besides being funny and entertaining, she is also a very kind, loving person who gives back to the community.
Thank you very much, Danielle Keeping. Hello, Kassar Jacobson. Hi, Kassar. I feel like I need to, but I won't. that I did. Kassar, you have said that we must be willing to challenge ourselves daily. It's amazing what I pick up as I just walk through the workshops and different things you say to people. Like, oh, that's good. I want to ask her that if she makes it to the final. So what are some things in life that you have done to really challenge yourself?
Thank you for that question. In my life, I used to be a very shy person, very afraid of public speaking, and most afraid of being on stage. So I have forced myself to be on stage for a few years now, and now I speak publicly, both within my personal life and within my career, and it has helped me immensely. And now I do my best to help other women, but I have learned so much from others that have helped grow me as a person inside.
Thank you, Kassar. Pleasure to meet you. Kendall and Jelkovic. Okay, now your message. I've enjoyed reading about the girl's message to the world. A little bit of kindness goes a long way. Tell us about a time in your life when somebody really showed extreme kindness to you.
I have to say this weekend, there have been multiple times where I have been almost brought to tears by the incredible generosity, selflessness, and above all, kindness that has been shown by not only you, but everyone else that is behind the scenes, and as well, the girls. These girls are not afraid to give the shirt off their back if it will help you to get further.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Kendall. And Amy, come on out and join us. One of the first girls I met as well this year. Amy, great to see you again. Very inspirational is something that I've heard all of the girls use to describe you. How would you describe what a powerful woman should be like?
That's a very good question, Darren. I believe that a powerful woman really embraces who she is, both inside and out, and really looks towards what you're passionate about and what you believe in, and embrace your positive and your negative. Because in this world, we have to really understand that we can never be perfect, but we can just be the best person that we are. So if we live our life with love, passion, and respect for others, I think that is what a powerful woman is. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Amy. My pleasure. Hello, Stephanie Monkman. Hi, Stephanie. Lots of energy we see from you. A marathon runner. That's absolutely incredible. What are some things you really have to do to train in order to have a successful marathon? And what are some amazing experiences you've had?
Well, the first thing is I gave myself 3 weeks to train for my first half marathon. With that, it was dedication, focus, and strength. I had to put everything I had into this one thing, and I would do everything to accomplish it. Once I accomplished my goal, I realized that I could do anything. If I put my mind to it, it was gonna happen. And I think part of doing something like that is believing in yourself. You need to understand that you have the capability to do things like that, and don't hold back. Just put everything out there that you have.
Thank you very much, Stephanie Monkman. Sandeep. Now, Sandeep, here we are. First time in an interview at a coffee shop in Carrimias when I was conducting interviews across the province, down in the finals on the stage here in BC. Congratulations. Now, one thing that you want to do in life is to help victims of bullying. As a teacher, I know that is an ongoing issue. What can be done about bullying?
Good evening, everyone. Bullying is an issue that affects every single one of us, whether we're 5 years old, whether we're 40, whether we're 60. And I believe that bullying is something that lives with you till the end. And the way that we can help bullying is by incorporating it into schools. In schools, we're taught about drug abuse, we're taught about sexual abuse, but we're not taught about bullying. And I would like to be a voice for the children that are victims of bullying. And I think we could do that by bringing it into the schools. Thank you.
Thank you, and a great voice that is. Thank you very much, Cindy. Jessica Wesson, come on out and see us. Hi, Jessica. All right, now I heard that someone you would love to meet is Beyonce. So if Beyonce was here, what would you like to ask?
If Beyonce was present, I would love to ask her how she pulled through with all the stress of being in its tough music business. An independent woman has to be strong, and Beyonce is definitely a woman that exudes self-confidence that I believe every woman should have no matter what in life.
Thank you very much, Jessica. I have Hannah Seaman come on out. Hi, Hannah. Hi, pleasure to see you again. Now, I guess this question is really pertains to you and to me, as the question is one thing you'd like to do is to teach teachers about stuttering. Teach me about this, some awareness as an educator of the children in BC about stuttering.
Thank you, Darren. One thing I have found since my Lella life has been affected by stuttering is that not many teachers are aware of what it is, and quite often they don't know how to deal with somebody who stutters. And as a result, I found growing up that teachers didn't understand, and I was left out of quite a few things, and I would love to have the opportunity just to explain to teachers that stuttering is, it makes me normal, and anyone else that is affected by it, it doesn't matter because they are just like everyone else and should be treated the same.
Thank you very much, Hannah Seaman, for teaching me something tonight. Thank you. Now, Cheryl, we're out of cards. I was having so much fun.
We did it.
We did. Now, you know what I thought when I called you up here and you weren't here? She said to me earlier today, she says, you know what, Darren, I am not giving up my crown. I've had too much fun, and I like you too much, aw, thanks, that I'm just not giving it up, and when you're, when I'm supposed to give it up, I'm just not going to be here.
Well, I tried to run for the door, and they stopped me.
Yes, of course, and I'm glad you came back. I do not want to finish this evening without you.
Thank you.
I could not do it.
Thank you.
And, ladies and gentlemen, we are moments away from revealing who will take home the titles of Miss and Mrs. BC 2012.
The Miss BC Pageant 2012 is sponsored by Save-On Foods Walnut Grove, Cobb's Bread, Tan Popo Sushi.
Here we go. Okay, first of all, we have our Heart and Soul Award. The first thing the girls did when they met is they got together and they told a story from their life to inspire each other, and then they voted on who was most inspiring to them. And the winner of the Heart and Soul Award is Svi Baines. Okay, now, People's Choice Award, you all had a part in this, and for the last 2 weeks, or the last week, you had the opportunity to vote online for People's Choice Award, and she who received the most votes is none other than Stephanie Monkman. Miss Congeniality. Yes, it was a movie, but here it's all about heart, I believe. And the ladies voted today for which one among them represented the spirit of friendship and kindness. Miss Congeniality for our show this year, Charmaine Ride. Okay, we begin now with the first of our Crown and Sash Awards. Miss Charity BC. Most of our ladies have participated in Cops for Cancer fundraisers across the province. And I'm first going to give you a total amount. $37,282.55. And and she is Desiree Tremblay, Miss Charity BC 2012. Miss BC Interior, all the way from that first little coffee shop in the interview in Karamias, Sandeep Banyag. Miss British Columbia Interior, joining her, Miss Vancouver Island from Nanaimo, Kendall Angelkovic. We have the interior, we have the island, and now we have Miss Greater Vancouver. Miss Greater Vancouver from Vancouver itself, Ada Gu. That brings us to Miss Lower Mainland, Vancouver, Kassar Jacobson. Miss Fraser Valley. Well, we're gonna have to figure out a way to fit two crowns on this lady, Miss Fraser Valley, Desiree Tremblay. I'm excited to see what Nadine's gonna do. Excellent choice. Okay. Mrs. Lower Mainland. Mrs. Lower Mainland, North Vancouver, Danielle Bermel. Delayed reaction. Okay, we now have our three provincial titles to give out. Okay, I hope I can do this properly. I think I can. Okay, we begin with Miss Teen BC. There are some ladies among our contestants who are 18 and 19, and we have are crowning a winner for the teen category, Miss Teen BC from Vancouver, Charmaine Laride. Okay, Mrs. British Columbia from Victoria, Amy Moranitz. We have Miss Teen BC, we have Mrs. BC, about to be joined by the new Miss British Columbia, who will lead us into another year of charity and represent communities across our province and continue as a spokesperson for Cops for Cancer and the Canadian Cancer Society. My pleasure to introduce to you tonight the new Miss British Columbia, Hannah Seaman from right here in Langley. Hannah, you are Miss British Columbia 2012, and your road starts here. Your journey begins now. From hundreds of applications all year to the 46 on stage tonight, to Hannah Seaman from right here in Langley, the new Miss British Columbia.
Every day.